Hi, I'm Countess deLesseps, and welcome to the Countess Report. Today we're in Watermel at the Watermel Center for students from across the world, from Germany, from Austria, from Croatia, just to name a few. There's very many students here. There's probably over 60. And Bob Wilson is the founder, and he is an artist and collector, and he's responsible for this whole thing. And he's been kind enough to bring some Malaysian chefs who are fabulous cooks, and I've been lucky enough to invite 10 of my very fancy friends to cook Malaysian food and feed the students from the Watermel Center. So thank you, Bob Wilson, and let's go and cook. And here is one of the girls arriving already. Hi, my darling. Mwah. You look fabulous. Thank you. At that top.
Isn't that sexy?
It's very sexy. What is that?
Mother pearl.
Wow. So tell everybody your name.
My name is Zilia.
Zilia from Monaco, one of my best friends in the whole world who came to learn how to cook Asian cuisine.
Mm-hmm. I'm waiting.
Okay, baby, let's go and cook. Let's go. Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. Thank you very much. How about yourself?
What is that accent? Now, I know you're European because you're a little bit late. I mean, the Europeans tend to be a little bit late. Anyway, we're glad to have you here for the cooking class. What is your name?
Brigitte.
Brigitte.
Von Ribbentrop.
Von Ribbentrop. That's a wonderful name. Where are you from in Germany?
From Frankfurt.
From Frankfurt. I've never been to Frankfurt. And what brings you to the Watermel Center? How did you find out about the Watermel Center?
I'm an old good friend of Bob's. So I go to basically everything he's producing in Europe, to Paris, to Brussels, to Berlin, London. So I think he's a genius.
He is a genius. I agree with you.
We have a house in Southampton, so I like to participate whatever they offer here.
So do you summer every summer here in the Hamptons?
Yes, I do. So that's a nice change from, you know, from just normal partying and sports, so it's different.
Yeah, a little bit of a culture.
Exactly.
Well, you know, nothing like the Europeans for culture. Thank you, Brigitte.
Thank you.
Brigitte? Brigitte.
Yeah, wonderful.
Brigitte. Okay, here's one of our fabulous girls from Southampton. What is your name?
Debbie Bancroft.
Debbie Bancroft. Now, why does that sound familiar? Why does that sound familiar?
Because I'm your friend.
I know that, but why else does it sound familiar? Don't we do like a Hampton style thing or something?
Yes, in fact, I'm the editorial director of Hampton Style, and I write a column for them. And I'm a supporter of Bob Wilson's. So.
And you live year-round out here in the Hamptons?
No, I live in the city. I'm out here for the summer.
I forgot that. I thought you were a year-rounder. Oh, God, I'm going to miss you in September. I'm going to miss you in September.
I consider staying out here longer. The idea of going back is just too gruesome.
I know, but you do weekends out here.
Yes, all year.
Oh, good. So you call me when you're out.
I promise.
Okay, in any case, we're going to get cooking now because we're all getting hungry.
Terrific. That's exciting. I'm always hungry.
Last two gals have finally got here. Of course, our fanciest friends, of course. Always the chicest ones are always the latest, you know? Well, no pun intended. Oh, the other ones are getting mad at me now. No, okay.
Well, so, I came from Paris, Kirath, all the way. That's why I'm late.
Oh, you see, she came from Paris. Debbie, don't get upset. She came from Paris. Debbie came from Southampton.
And not Paris, Texas, I have to tell you. No. So.
Darling, Kira Young, right?
Yes.
And she makes the most fantastic jewelry, which is actually a Nina Griscom store in Southampton. Now, Nina has a new store in Southampton, which we've all heard about, or maybe some of us haven't heard about, with name, Anthony Todd?
Well, we're partners. Anthony Todd, Nina Griscom is the name of the store. Mm-hmm. We're at 28 Jobs Lane in Southampton.
Great.
And I'm wearing a bracelet. Wow. To die as well as your
yeah, anyway, and this is all Kirat's things here. No, when they came to learn how to cook the Malaysian food, but I'm so happy they came because they make such great
We're both
figures
foodies,
of,
yes, and we love great food. We love you.
Oh, thank you, sweetheart. Thank you.
A lot of the Malaysian food is, you know, inspired from India, so since I'm Indian.
Exactly. And you know what, sweetheart? You missed a bit of the preparation, but you're lucky because now you're going to get to see the preparation and actually get to eat it.
That's
so I can't wait to see the meat the cooks.
And Nina, are you going to be out here the whole summer?
Indeed I am.
And on weekends too?
Yep.
Good. Thank you. I'll have somebody to come and visit on the weekend.
10 to 7,
I'll just run into your store and come and say hi.
Great.
All right. Thanks,
all right,
girls. Let's go and eat now. Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. Here she is. Are we on? Are we on? Okay. Well, look, Kimmy is here, and she called me 2 minutes ago and said, how are you dressing?
I did.
And you know what, lovey? You did a great job. You look fabulous.
I tried.
Huh? So are you ready to cook some Malaysian food?
I am.
Learn how to cook? But you're a big cook in any case, huh?
Of course I am.
I've eaten some really good food that she's cooked. Huh? Well, now we're going to teach you Malaysian food. So let's get going because we start a little bit late. But you know what, darling? It was worth the wait. You look fabulous. All the girls. Kimmy's here.
Hi, how are you?
So this is another one of the fancy girls joining us for dinner, and her name is Mei Mujan. She's a very good friend of mine, and she's actually a part of the Watermill Center, and I'm going to let her tell you a little bit about herself.
Hi.
Hi, Mei.
Hello. I have been here for 5 years, and I am the community co-chair of the Watermill Center Community Board, and we do an outreach program, and so we thought we'd do a cooking class with women who wanted to learn how to cook with our chefs, Jennifer and Zoe, who are from Indonesia. And so here we are in the kitchen that is here at the Watermill Center. And Robert Wilson's Watermill Center has been open for 11 years. It's our 11th summer. And hopefully we'll
Fantastic.
Be open in 14 months, and we can invite the public to come. And who knows where this cooking class may go. It might become a full-time thing.
Thank you, Mei. You're wonderful. So let's get cooking. I'm glad that you came tonight to do the cooking course. Tell me, what are you doing out here in the Hamptons, and how do you know about the Watermill Center?
I have been here a mile away for the last 23 years, and this summer I'm fortunate enough to be part of what goes on here, and I truly value the opportunity to get involved.
And you have a house out here?
I have a house a mile away, but for the last 20 years I've lived in Los Angeles. So I'm particularly interested in Asian cooking because we're much closer to Asia than you are here, and it's one of the real benefits to living out there.
So you summer out here every year, coming from California?
August. Yeah, I'm very
lucky. Oh, just August.
Just August, but I consider myself so lucky.
Well, it's one of the greatest months to be in the Hamptons in any case.
Absolutely, and a bad month to be in L.A.
Well, thanks for coming. And
thank you.
Let's go and cook something.
Absolutely. Thanks.
Another one of my girlfriends, fabulous girlfriends, has arrived for the cooking class, and this is Debbie Loeffler. And Debbie is very interested in cooking, isn't that right?
That's right. I try my very best, but I never made food like this before.
What have you made before? I know you have a garden filled with apples.
Yeah,
you told me that the
organic
other night.
Apples.
Organic apples, but what do you do with the apples?
I make a lot of applesauce. That's what everybody does with a lot of apples.
Now, girls, how could we apply apples to your cooking? Is there any way we can introduce Debbie's apples to your cooking? What do you do with apples?
Oh, sometimes we cook it with meat to give it a nice tangy flavor, or even in cakes, salads.
Mm-hmm.
You can use it in a lot of different kinds of salads.
Now, did you bring any apples tonight?
It's not the season.
Oh, it's not apple
Obviously,
season?
You don't have an apple tree.
I don't have an apple tree, darling. So
be
it's
a little early.
Got
to wait another month or so.
So, girls, we're cooking how many dishes that we said? Five or six different
doing
dishes?
Five different dishes.
You okay. Want to need a hairnet?
Does
no,
Debbie need
I
a hairnet? You don't need a hairnet? Okay, Deb, so we're going to get started very soon. We're
Good,
so
I'm ready.
Happy you're going to be
go
with
wash
us.
Up.
Okay, let's go wash. Now, from the moment I walked into this kitchen, which is filled with the most incredible fresh produce, I've been asking the girls, what are these bags of plastic with water inside that are hanging here from the ceiling? And they actually told me that these bags are for the flies. And what happens is the flies see themselves, the reflection in the bag, and they get scared because they're bigger than their normal selves, and so they run out of the kitchen, which I think is a very interesting way to get rid of flies. I mean, I've never heard of that. Have you guys ever heard of that?
Yes.
Have you? Oh, Zilia's heard of that, you see? Anyway, I think, is it a Malaysian thing?
No, it's actually the Watermill tradition here.
Oh, it's a Watermill Center tradition. Isn't that interesting, girls? I'm going to try this in my own house. Yeah. Hi, ladies. Here we are in the kitchen with all this gorgeous, fantastic food. And I know you're fantastic chefs because I've tasted the food that you make already. Can you just introduce yourself to WVVH?
Mm-hmm. Hi, I'm Zoe. I'm from Malaysia. And I'm here to cook the Asian food for the whole of the Watermill Center for 6 weeks.
Fantastic. And you are?
I'm Jennifer. I'm also from Malaysia, and I'm doing exactly the same as Zoe.
Fantastic. So tell me, ladies, we have 10 ladies who are going to come and help us cook. What are we cooking for dinner tonight?
Okay. We're going to do several different Asian food. We start with the Malaysian fried beef satay and chicken as well. And then we'll do tom kha kai, which is a Thai chicken soup with mm-hmm. mushrooms.
Oh, I know that. That's good.
Yeah,
I love
it's
that.
Good. It's good. And what else, Jennifer?
We're doing the salmon with tandoori baked.
Is this the salmon right
yes,
here?
Yes. It's been
Beautiful.
Marinated with spices.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll wrap it up in banana leaf and grill it on the grill.
Wow. And where's all the grills?
The grills are just outside.
So we're gonna go and look at the grills after. Mm-hmm. But anyway, where do you get all of your produce from? Where do you buy all the food?
Oh, it's all from Chinatown.
From Chinatown?
Everything. We get all our ingredients from Chinatown.
Yeah, but you have a lot of fresh vegetables and things here. You must get a lot of that here.
Of course, the fresh vegetables and meat, we get it from here. You know, that's not, I mean, we can't store it all the, you
no,
know.
No, and the produce here is so good.
It is,
the local
yes.
produce is fantastic. So we've got 10 girls coming to cook. What are the girls going to be doing exactly so I can give them fair warning? Because they're a bit fancy, these girls. I don't know. We have to warn them.
Well, basically, we've prepared everything. And while we're cooking, they will pass out the sheets that will say what the ingredients are, and they'll see how we do it. So basically, the preparation's done, so all the food will be, we'll tell them what is what, mm-hmm. and then we'll take it from there.
Okay, we're ready.
So now we're going to demonstrate what we're going to cook. Ladies, are you ready?
Yeah.
Now, keep your questions, you know, to yourselves for the moment until we're ready. And I'll say, go, and you can all speak at the same time. No, just joking. Okay, so what are we starting with first, Zoe?
Okay, we're starting with the Malaysian fried satay, which is the easiest way to prepare satay, rather than putting them on skewers and sitting in front of the grill. So we're going to do it really easy. I have chicken here, which has been cubed and marinated in all the spices.
Have we seen the chicken? Look at the chicken, girls. Here's the chicken.
That's
looks a little bit messy, but I'm sure it's going to be delicious.
That's all the spices that's been ground.
Okay, that's the chicken. Spices. What spices go in there?
We have lemongrass, garlic, chilies, some peanuts, and galangal, ginger, and some seasoning with soy sauce, sugar, salt, and pepper.
What's a galangal?
Galangal is a kind of root, very similar to ginger, but it's much harder. It's very hard, but it has a very strong aroma.
And you cut the meat in really tiny pieces?
This time, because we're doing it very easy and we're cooking for like 80 people, so we do it in very thin slices. The meat is very tender, so it cooks fast.
Wow, that's a lot of meat.
That's a lot of
meat. That's a lot of hungry students.
Exactly.
Okay. All right. So this is part of this is another dish.
That's the satay.
This is the satay.
Okay. One is chicken. One is beef.
Beef satay and chicken
satay. As well.
But, okay. Very good. Mm-hmm. All right, girls. Any questions about the satay?
Can you do it with a fish?
You can definitely.
Yes.
Fish, lamb, yes.
Anything. Can you show us the galangal? Do you have one?
Sure.
Yes.
And so we've got all our list of ingredients here, so that's great. So we already know how to do this, girls. We just have to kind of mush it all up in the chicken and the beef and
is
let it sit
root?
For a while.
Is this the root?
Yeah.
It looks like a ginger root.
Does it look like ginger?
It looks like a ginger.
It looks like ginger. It's much darker in color. It's more pinkish.
Chinatown.
And you can freeze it.
Very difficult.
You can freeze it.
You can freeze it
for a long time.
Yeah.
You can buy them frozen, and it lasts for a long, long time.
Now, how long did this stuff how long do you have to keep this marinating, kind of?
Minimum 45 minutes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Great. Mm-hmm. All right. So that's the satays. Let's move on to the next yummy thing. You girls want to know more about this one? No? Okay. So what do we have next? What are we making next?
Next will be the. Let me have a look. Fish tandoori.
Is that this?
Yeah.
Wow. What is on top of all that fish?
It's fresh salmon, so it's marinated with yogurt, garlic, ginger, onion, salt, lime juice, cinnamon powder, and chili powder.
Is that a 45-minute marinade as well?
45 minutes to an hour.
Okay, and how do you cook it then after?
I'm going to wrap it up in the banana leaf.
Okay.
Show you how it's done.
Oh, yeah, let's see that. Let's see that. She's got the banana leaf right here.
The banana leaf.
Chinatown.
Chinatown, and you can buy it and freeze it.
Either that or send it on the jitney.
So it's all marinated, and then place it on the banana leaf, and you wrap it.
Wow, that looks fabulous. And that must keep it nice and moist when it's cooking.
Yes, it sort of keeps the juices in. Let me wash my hands.
Okay, she's going to wash her hands now. And but how do you cook that on a grill? Okay, rather than in a wok or something like that.
Or you can put it in the oven as well.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. And that looks gorgeous.
And then you just seal the sides with toothpicks and then just place it on the grill.
Place it on the grill. Okay. So that's our third dish. Now, I know we have a salad, don't we? Do we have salad?
We don't have.
You tell me what you want to do.
Okay. The next dish will be the tom kha kai, which is the chicken, Thai chicken soup. It's very easy to do. You start with lemongrass, just crush like that, you know, just with a...
Oh, can I smell that?
Yes.
Girls, we love lemongrass. That's so good. And now, lemongrass you can get here.
You can, yes.
You can get it here.
You just put it in whole, like this?
Yes. It's just the scent that you want.
Is it? Yeah. It's chopped, though, I think, right? You chop it, or no?
No.
You put it like that?
Yeah, just like that.
Okay.
Then we have ginger, galangal.
Galangal, there's the galangal.
Cafe lime leaves, which has got a very nice aroma as well.
Can I smell that?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's almost like how you call that? It's like a lemon, lemony, limey zest. So smells so fresh, so good.
And then you have chilies.
Ooh, who wants to eat a chili? Anybody? No?
Thai chilies.
Okay.
Then you have straw mushrooms.
Straw mushrooms.
Yeah, it comes in a can, but it's a necessity for this soup.
It does, you know, it's incredible because there's not really that many ingredients. It's not that difficult. No. Girls, we could actually pull this off.
Now,
right?
Are the lime leaves, again, you purchase those in Chinatown?
Yes.
And freeze them.
You can buy them here, yeah. You can buy those here. Okay. Right, so that is the, can you tell me again what's the name of that soup?
Tom kha kai. Kai is chicken in Thai.
Tom kha kai. All right.
Tom kha is soup. And kai is chicken.
Okay, so that's the Malaysian type of kai. Okay, so that's the soup.
Mm-hmm.
And that's our fourth thing. And we have one more thing, right?
We have the Chinese vegetables.
Oh, we love vegetables.
Which is another easy one.
Uh-huh.
It's just any kind of Chinese leafy type vegetables chopped into small pieces.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have garlic, onions, crushed.
You have to see all these. Yum. Yeah. Look at all these ingredients for the soup.
Yeah.
And that's going to be good.
And you sauté it very fast, very quickly over the wok.
Okay. So, and those are all local fresh vegetables. We got a picture of all those
all
little
from,
local
Hamptons,
Hamptons vegetables.
Yes.
Okay, girls. So when are we going to start cooking?
Whenever. Now.
Yeah?
Now.
What time are the students expecting dinner?
Usually about 8:30.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So I think we have some time for some wine, girls, before dinner starts. And then we can cook, but we're going to cook outside, actually, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so maybe we can move over to the grill area in just a bit. I found some students of the Watermill Center, very handsome students, I might add. And what is your name?
Makram Hamdan.
And what are you doing over here at the Watermill Center?
I'm a dancer and a choreographer, and I also work here in the garden.
Mm-hmm.
And been working with Bob since 1992.
And are you working now on a particular piece for Bob?
Yes, I'm working on 11 Commandments.
Mm-hmm.
It's a piece that's being done in France with the Conservatory of Dramatic Arts in Paris, and it'll be in 2006.
That's exciting.
Yes.
Great.
Exciting.
So how long are you staying?
Till the end of August.
Okay. And then you're back to?
Then I go back to work with Bob again on a tour of Aida at the Royal Opera House in Brussels and the Netherlands Dance Theater, which will tour through Luxembourg and Brussels, Germany.
Just love the Lebanese. They're
yes.
so sexy. Oh, okay. And you are?
I'm Christoph from Germany.
Where in Germany are you from?
Close to Nuremberg, from the south, south of Germany.
Okay, and you're working here at the center as well?
Yeah, I do. I'm substituting Christoph, another Christoph, who is Bob Wilson's assistant. Mm-hmm. And hopefully I will do his job from December, January on.
Okay, so do you stay out here doing that job, or are you traveling with Bob?
Well, from December, January on, I would travel with Bob mm-hmm. everywhere where he goes around the world. Yeah, basically that.
And how long have you been working with him?
Now, just a couple of days.
Oh, okay, so you just arrived.
Yeah, just 1 week ago.
Okay.
And the other Christoph is on vacation, so...
Oh, I see. So when Christoph comes back, he still works here as well, or...?
Yeah, and then they go to Europe.
I hope so for poor Christoph.
Yeah. He doesn't lose his job.
Oh, good. I'm glad to hear that.
Yeah, don't worry. Okay. And then he works with him until December. They will go to Europe next week.
Well, thank you, guys. I'm sure you're having the best time here.
Thank you. We are.
Huh?
Definitely.
Good.
Very
all right.
Much.
Well, let's go and eat. Definitely. I'm hungry. How about you?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go and eat.
Excellent food.
How long you've been here at the center, and what you're doing here, and what your names are?
I'm Leiko Shima, Japanese, coming from Paris, because I live in Paris as an architect, and I'm doing with Mr. Wilson the project of La Fable, the exhibition in the gallery of La Fondation Yves Saint Laurent.
That sounds very important. That's fabulous. And you are?
I'm Jørid from Norway. I've been here for 4 weeks, and I'm doing different things, also this exhibition, and we'll start a Norwegian project as well tomorrow.
You have the most incredible green eyes. Look at her eyes. Did you see her eyes? And look at this gorgeous man over here. Where are you from?
I'm from Indonesia. Bob in here tell me see the work in the watermill. I'm here 1 month. It's a long time, but I'm happy.
Do you miss your family?
Not yet, because I have new family in here.
Oh, I can imagine you're having a great time. I've actually seen him perform. He's unbelievable. You stand so still on your feet in those performances. It's wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you.
And I have another one over here. He's hiding, but he's American. But we can say we're American. It's fine.
That's right.
What is your name, hon?
I'm Matt.
And what are you doing here at the center? I've seen you perform as well.
I'm a performer. I'm an actor in New York City.
Wonderful. And how long are you going to be here at the center?
I'll be here for this last week, and then back to the city.
Great. I'm sure it's been a fantastic experience,
yeah.
No?
Yeah.
Good. Thanks a lot. Now, Kim Hairston is a really, really good friend of mine, and she is the hottest art consultant in New York. Now, I wanted to ask you, she invited me, first of all, to the Watermill Benefit to sit at her table, which was absolutely fabulous. And I remember you bidding on some piece of art. I can't remember what it was. You tell me, because I'm not so...
David Hockney.
Oh, it was a Hockney. Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot.
A watercolor by David Hockney, yeah. And a work called Black Christ by Andre Serrano.
Okay.
And then
I remember you bidding on a couple things. I lost track after a while.
I also bid on the concert, the home concert by John Cage. Mm-hmm. And I'm sorry, forgive me, Philip Glass.
Oh, and, we forgive you.
Forgive me. I didn't get that, but I did get the Serrano and I did get the Hockney. And
so those clients out there, better hurry up.
Are you keeping them
for yourself?
No, actually, they are for clients.
They are for clients.
But I did buy a few things for myself in the silent auction, so that was fun.
Now, tell me, you've been coming to the Watermill Center, I know,
for years.
So
how did you get affiliated
with the Watermill Center and Bob Wilson and the whole thing?
Well, I sort of have been aware of Bob for many, many years, mostly through the art world. He's represented by Paula Cooper, who's one of the finest gallerists on the face of the earth. And I've known his work primarily through, both his sculpture and as well as his performances. Well, not performances, he directs.
Right, and composes.
He directs and composes, and Bob does does everything. Right. He's amazing. He's a theater director. He's a sculptor. He's a person who puts it all together in a most amazing way. And I think he's a genius. And so I got very excited. I mean, I think I think we better
go and tell him that.
Where are you?
You're single, right? Well, not for long.
And you have a house out here, actually?
I have a house out here, and I come every year. And this is the one event that I don't miss because it's a wonderful mix of theater and art and music. And again, mostly art, but it's a wonderful mix of people, and it's probably one of the most glamorous events and the most intelligent events and the most gloriously beautiful events that takes place out here.
I have to agree with you, and I must say I'm so happy that I get invited every year to be with Kim at her table next year. Well, thank you, Kim Houston.
You're welcome.
I love you, baby. Thank you. Mwah.
Mwah. Thanks.
This is the Tom Konkai. Where are the chefs? That's the Tom Konkai. There we have the beef satay. And what do you have over there, darling? That's salmon. The salmon, as Zilia would say, from Monaco. Anyway, girls, this looks fabulous.
And this is yogurt.
I need two hands though to get this in my plate. Or you want to serve me?
Yes.
Thank you, Kirat. You're a love. That's the yogurt sauce that goes with the beef.
And this is the
Who wants to hand me some beef? Debbie, you're on to beef for me.
Right.
Hand me some beef, sweetie.
I give you some
okay, there's the chicken. There's the beef.
Then you need this,
and the salmon too. Okay, give me everything. Give me some of that. Give me some of that. Okay. Girls, what do you think? This looks fabulous. We can do this. We can do this at our house, right? We can do this at our house. No problem. It is good for you. Listen to Kirat, the health nut. It's good for you too. Girls, hello. Are we happy yet? Hello. Oh, I hate that. I can't believe I just said that. Look at this. Are you happy?
Totally
Brigitte?
Happy.
Brigitte?
It's so delicious.
What's your favorite thing?
The soup.
Ah, the Tom Kakai, our favorite thing, the Tom Kakai.
Yeah, what's your favorite thing?
Yes, mine is
the salmon?
Salmon.
The salmon wrapped in the leaf.
I love
the salmon. Kimmy?
I haven't had everything yet.
She can't speak.
I can't speak. I'm in heaven.
How about Nina?
The pad thai.
Okay. The pad thai. Debbie? We have to have Debbie's opinion.
I said Let's I love Debbie. Tom's Kakai.
She's our comedian.
Is he missing
Zilia from Monaco. What does Zilia from Monaco have to say?
I love everything. I'm hungry.
You're a smart woman.
Everything.
Everybody? May? May Mujan?
The salmon.
Your favorite, though. I didn't ask you the favorite thing.
Oh, the cabbage.
Everybody has a favorite. The cabbage?
Where are the cabbage?
How very vegetarian of you. Okay, girls, let's have a toast. Let's have a toast to this fantastic dinner. Good friends. And the wonderful weather of the Hamptons and the Bob Wilson Center. Watermill Center. Cheers, girl. Oh, wait.
Cheers to you.
To Jennifer and Zoe. They did a great job.
Yeah, good night. Good night.